and I'm going to want to go to the apartment. I was there for a couple of years. So I went with the ghost from having experience and then some detection, biodetection, or biodecontamination. So we were trying to evaluate technologies for detection agents, the biotech agents, or looking at technologies to kill those agents that were decontaminations. In the United States, we have four biosafety levels, 1, 2, 3, 4. Biosafety level 3 is involving agents that can be transmitted in air, C4E, and they can make you sick, but we still have cures and treatments for you. So there are other drugs available or your vaccines that you can take. So biosafety level 3 would be working typically on a respirator that's going to keep you from breathing any organisms that you're working with, just keep you safe. It has negative pressure so that that room, if you open the door, you know, things are not going to flow out of the laboratory. The air's going to come in. So there's some engineering controls that are taken into account in biosafety level 3 that are present for level 1 and level 2. We entered into a cooperative research and development agreement or credit with a company, ECBC, that was signed this year. So we are now researching and coming up with data produced on decom data. We are assessing its effectiveness and its decomming biothreat agents. We're working with that company to evaluate this product to see how well it can decontaminate biological threat agents. Generally contains disinfectant, and it takes permanent or paint on objects or surfaces. And it will actually localize the agent within the gel. Once it dries, you just simply can peel it off, just like tape or film, and it will remove and retain that threat agent. So we're using the gel to actually to decom surgical equipment. This is a DARPA funding program. So we're actually using a 3D printer to design and print surgical instruments such as forceps or scalpels. And we are using the decom gel to assess how well it can decom bacteria on those two surgical instruments. Biodefense research is vital to continue to protect the warfighter and the nation from potential threats. So we have to be ready, we have to be able to respond, able to counter threats, to detect ourselves and to counter those threats. In my direction, Taylor conducts biodefense research to do just that. BFPI on the program, again, takes a year project from beginning to end, and in some instances, see that technology field with for some 2 years. That has a great success and sustained rewarding. I served for a number of years on the Army's Loyal Monitor Program, where we were evaluating technologies for detection of biological agents in water. And that was one in particular where I actually got to see that in the field that soldiers are actually using. We built a water test kit that contains antibodies, adversaries for detection of biological toxins in water. So soldiers can screen water with more consumption and ensure that it is safe to drink. The fact that I get to do it in the water, I'm going to make it with a struggle that I need to pay for. My friend is an